you got to think about this too, Mish. Like when we're talking about, you know, them cutting Sheamus off the show, them shutting the New Day off, it was way more important for them to get Happy Corbin on the program tonight. That was a pivotal part of the show for them to have Happy Corbin, who has now moved away from Five Finger Death Punch Biker to become a sickly tapeworm fucking Lubega. That needed to be on the show. That was vital to the show's quality. And why would we ever want to put the New Day on there when we could have Drew McIntyre and his sword go way too long with a guy that probably shouldn't even be on the card at this point?
I think you're selling Happy Corbin a little short. I mean, did you not see that wonderful video package of when he was a bum on the side and they were asking him, is he still going to continue to wrestle because he's now a bum? And then he
bum ass.
And then he made all of his money in Vegas, more money than you would make in a year. So, and now all of a sudden they showed the rags to riches story of Happy Corbin. How could you not support a guy that has come up from the ground like that? It really is touching
that,
to feels.
The only thing that promo reminded me of is the fact that in 8 years, that was the only 3 months of it he's been entertaining.
You know, the big thing about this match was the fact, and I didn't even realize this, it just shows you how much I care about Baron Corbin. Nobody has ever kicked out of the End of Days. And today, Drew McIntyre kicked out of the End of Days. So they were making that big deal as history.
Yeah, that was the big historic deal, guys. Baron Corbin's End of Days got kicked out from. Jesus. I mean, no. Move over, Stone Cold. Move over, Cody Rhodes. The End of Days got kicked out of, guys.